I'm Emmy Saunders, Assistant Curator at the Springs Preserve, and we're here today at Well Number 1 and the Settling Basin to talk about well technology in Las Vegas. In the early days of Las Vegas, the water that was in the aquifer under the ground, the quality was great, but once it reached the surface, they ran into some issues with the quality of that water. It would come into contact with people and livestock and algae and weeds. Sometimes frogs would even get right into the pipes. So the Las Vegas Land and Water Company needed a way to get plenty of fresh, clean water to Las Vegas. So they decided in 1924 to build Well Number 1. Now, Well Number 1 went right down to the aquifer, and when it came up, it brought up 3,600 gallons of water from the aquifer. But it also stirred up quite a lot of dirt and dust and debris. So all of that debris would need to settle out of the water. This is a great representation of that right here. So the water would come up Well Number 1 through artesian force and enter the settling basin here. The sediment would settle to the bottom using gravity, and the clean water would stay closer to the top. It would then exit the settling basin and enter into the pipe system going to Las Vegas. So if we compare Well Number 1 to the well behind me, which is a more modern well, Well Number 34, the technology has come a really long way. There's now electric pumps and more sophisticated filtering systems to keep that water safe and clean through the pipes. In the early days of Las Vegas, all of the water for the town came from Well Number 1 or from the three springs on the Springs Preserve site. But now, only 10% of our water comes from groundwater in Las Vegas. The rest of it comes from Lake Mead. There are about 100 active permitted wells between the Las Vegas Valley Water District and North Las Vegas, currently adding water to our water system. So that's a little bit about wells in Las Vegas. Thanks for watching this edition of Vegas Valley Water History. See you next time.